Namaste, my student. Today I am going to continue exercise 2.1. In this video, I am going to show you how to solve question number 5, 6 and 7. This exercise is related to the addition and subtraction of fraction. So let us see. Question number 5. Find the perimeter of triangle ABE. See in this figure. So we have to find the perimeter of this triangle ABE. Here the side length is given in a fraction form. We have to find out the perimeter of this triangle. Then the second part, we have to find the rectangle BCDE. Perimeter of the rectangle BCDE. Okay. So we need to find first the perimeter of triangle, then the perimeter of rectangle. Okay. So now after finding, we have to compare whose perimeter is greater. In my previous video, I have shown you an example how to compare two fractions. You have to use it over here to solve this part. So let us begin. From the figure, you will write it down first of all, what are the sides length. Okay. So I have written whatever it is provided in the figure, like side AB equal to 5/2 cm. Same way, I have written all the length of the sides, that is BE, AE and DE. Okay. After writing, now let us proceed. You will write perimeter of triangle ABE because we need to find the first triangle ABE perimeter. So what is the perimeter of triangle? In class 6, we have learned that perimeter of triangle is equal to sum of three sides. So write down sum of three sides. What are the three sides? AB, BE plus AE. Okay. After writing, now put their value. AV value is what? 5/2. BE is 2/3/4. AE is 3/3/5. See over here, I have shown you the process. These two are a mixed fraction. You have to convert the mixed fraction to an improper fraction. See, I have shown you the process. In my previous video, I have taught you how to convert the mixed to an improper. Follow that. So how will you do? Keep this denominator as it is 4. Then what you will do? 4 into 2, then plus 3. After finding out, after doing the calculation, I got 11/4. Write down 11/4 in place of this mixed fraction. Same way, 3/3/5. What you will do? Write the denominator as it is, then 5 into 3 plus 3. Do the solution, do the calculation. Then after finding the solution, what it is? 18/5. Write it down over here. Now after getting this, what you need to do? Here I can see it is a unlike fraction, right? These three are an unlike fraction. We have to convert this three fraction to a like fraction where the denominator, where there should be a common denominator. So what you will do? What we have learned, we will find the LCM. LCM of 2, 4, 5. So LCM of 2, 4, 5 is equal to 20. Then after finding out the LCM, what you will do? You will convert to an equivalent fraction where denominator should be 20. How I get 20? I will find out the number that I need to multiply with the numerator as well. 2 into 10 is 20. Multiply the 10 with numerator. What you are getting? 50/20. Right? Then next, 11/4. Convert to an equivalent fraction. 4 into 5 is 20. 11 into 5 is 55. Same way, 18/5. That is 20, 5 into 4 is 20, 18 into 4 is 72. I got all the equivalent fraction. Put it over here and do the calculation. 50/20 plus 55/20 plus 72/20. Now it is easier for you to do the addition. Put the common denominator as it is 20. Now add the numerator. 50 plus 55 plus 72. Okay. Now after adding, I will get the answer as 177/20. So this is the perimeter of triangle ABE. Okay. So I got the perimeter of triangle ABE. Now, we need to find the perimeter of rectangle BCDE. We have to find the perimeter of this rectangle. What we have learned in class 6, perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into length plus breadth. Here the length is 2 3 by 4, that is the BE. BE is the length. Okay, I will write down the length. Then what is the breadth? Breadth is the DE. I will write down the length. I will write down the measurement of the breadth, that is 7 by 6 centimeter. Okay, now after writing down, now let us put it in the formula. 2 into what is the value of the length? That is 2 3 by 4. Write it down. What is the value of the breadth? 7 by 6. Write it down. And now you will convert this mixed fraction to an improper fraction as 2 3 by 4. Here already I have converted. See, I got it 11 by 4. Write it over here. Now let us begin our calculation. Here I can see these two are an unlike fraction. So I will convert into a to a like fraction where the denominator should be a common. So let us do LCM of 4 and 6. LCM of 4 and 6 is equal to 12. So 11 by 4 convert to an equivalent fraction where denominator is 12. So 4 into 3 is 12. I will multiply the same number with the numerator, that is 33 by 12. Same way, 7 by 6 equivalent fraction, I can see 6 into 2 is 12, so I will multiply 2 with the numerator as well. I am getting 14 by 12. Now put the value. 2 should be there because the formula is telling we need to multiply with 2. Right, now you have to do the addition then multiply with 2. So let us put the equivalent fraction value over here. 33 by 12 plus 14 by 12. What you are getting? 2 into 12, 33 plus 14 will give you what? 47. Okay, so now I can do the division over here. 47 by 6. So this is the answer. You have to convert to an mixed fraction. So now what you will be doing, it is told over here that whose perimeter is greater. Let us compare the perimeter of triangle ABE and perimeter of rectangle BCDE. Write it down. Perimeter of triangle ABE, that is equal to 177 by 20, and perimeter of rectangle BCDE is equal to 47 by 6. Now you have to compare these two fractions. How you are going to compare? I can see both are unlike fraction. Find the common denominator. So LCM of 20 and 6, that is equal to 60. Okay, and convert it into an equivalent fraction where denominator is a 60. So what I am getting over here? 20 into 3 is 60, and 177 into 3, that is equal to 531 by 60. Same way, 47 by 60 by 6, convert to an common denominator, that is 60 should be there. What I am getting? 6 into 10 is 60, 47 into 10 is 470. Okay, so now what you are getting now over here? So after solving, what we got? 177 by 20, that is equal to 531 by 60, and 47 by 6 we have converted to a 470 by 60. So now both are in a like fraction. Compare it. So if you compare 531 by 60 and 470 by 60, which is a greater one? I can see 531 is greater than 470. So this fraction is greater than this fraction. So that is 177 by 20 is greater than 47 by 6. So this is the perimeter of triangle and this is the perimeter of rectangle. So perimeter of triangle is greater than perimeter of rectangle. So write it down. Perimeter of triangle ABE is greater than perimeter of rectangle BCDE. So this is the end of the video. In this video, I have just shown about how to solve question number 5. In the next video, I'm going to continue this exercise. I'm going to show you question number 6 and 7. Following this video, you can do the question number 4. In the question number 4, it is told to find the perimeter of rectangle. I think after going through this sum, you have understood how to do it. You can easily do question number 4. Thank you. Namaskar.